But it's been about a month since our last presidential prayer watch update. You know, this was birthed out of the On Earth as It Is in Heaven conference we had here in August. And if there was any good fruit, that was the greatest of the fruit because, and by the way, we have, and those of you that received this video, we had now up to 850 people that have signed up that are praying for the president. You know, and maybe some have, you know, dropped out, I don't know, or grown weary, but I pray not because we need everyone. If you have two or more, that's a pretty good majority. But if history properly records this hour and the events and the people that God are using, I believe that it will be known that there was a remnant of intercessors that helped tilt the scales, and they wouldn't back down, and they were praying, and they're going to be used as a part of the salvation of multitudes, and even a nation. Can a nation be saved? Absolutely. And for those of you that have stayed on the course over these now many months praying, you know, different times when you signed up, we've seen answered prayers. But to put it mildly, the warfare is intensifying. And I was thinking this week, Job 30, Job's trying to explain what happened, what's going on in his life and discerning. Here's what he said. He said, "They break up my path. They promote my calamity. They come as broad breakers. Under the ruinous storm, they roll along." The ruinous storm. And it just seemed to come to me that, you know, the storms can bring ruin. Growing up in Louisiana, I saw a lot of ruin from hurricanes. But, you know, it's often what happens after the storm or under the storm. It's what's behind the scenes that can bring the greatest ruin. Sometimes the storms are men created while they're working behind the scenes to do things that are more diabolical. And that's happening in America. Now, Acts chapter 14, verse 22. Paul, let me just remind you of this. He says when he had preached the gospel to a certain city, he said he came back strengthening the souls of the disciples, exhorting them to continue in the faith. I'm exhorting you this morning. Continue in the prayer. It says, "For we must through many tribulations enter the kingdom of God." And there's going to be a lot of tribulation. And so what we have to continue. Now, some of you I know are saying, how can I continue to pray effectively for the president? First of all, it's obvious he's not a perfect man. But God doesn't choose based on whether someone is perfect. He chooses based on his will, what he sees. And then, you know, some are seeing all the shaking going on. A lot of shaking this week and in the government. And they're seeing the upheaval and they say the chaos and it's an ineptness. Some are saying it's just is the ineptness of man. But really, we got to remember who's behind the shaking. So that's the purpose of this update. Remember, Hebrews, let me just remind you, then we're going to pray for you guys because you cannot grow weary in well-doing. We will reap if we do not faint. If we faint, at that conference we were challenged and we were told what happens if we faint. We cannot faint. And we've taken this serious. In my book, you guys, 850 and the people that are part, we are tilting the scales. We are standing in the gap. Now, there are many people and groups out there. Some of them you don't hear from anymore. They started well. We're going to end well by the grace of God and by encouraging one another. But Hebrews, he talks about, he says, now this yet once more indicates, or he says, yet once more I shake not only earth but heaven. Yet once more indicates a removal. Remember that word, removal of those things that are being shaken as of things that are made. That the things which cannot be shaken may remain. Therefore, since we're receiving a kingdom which cannot be shaken. Three things, real quickly. Number one, God said, "I will shake." God's behind the shaking. It's going to increase. Secondly, the purpose is the removal of those things that shouldn't be there in the first place. And that man created. And then third, so that which cannot be shaken may remain. Do you know anything that cannot be shaken? The kingdom. We enter the kingdom through much tribulation. We're receiving a kingdom. Now, this is interesting. The word "I will shake" means to rock sideways, to or fro, to agitate in any direction, to cause to tremble, to throw into a tremor of fear or concern, to move, quake, and shake. But there are two Greek words for shake. The other is shook in that scripture. And it means to waver, to agitate, rock, topple, disturb, destroy, and incite. Stir up. You know, all that's happening right now. And then the word removal. Now this blew me away. It means transferal to heaven. Huh? Transferal to it's something's happening right now. The kingdom of God is emerging. The kingdoms of men. Anyway, it also means the disestablishment of a law. The change, removing, or translation. Getting rid of what man created so that God, the things of God are eternal. Now remember, the Roman believers, you know, they needed to be strengthened. I'm exhorting you, continue in the prayer regardless of what the media is telling you. Listen to God's media. God's behind the shaking. And He has a purpose. And also, from the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent take it by force. They don't sit there. There are many Christians sitting on the sideline in this hour. Get in the battle. You guys, you 850, you're engaged in one of, I believe it's one of the epic battles of the last days. If you knew how big this battle was and the souls that are hanging in the balance and the soul of the nation. And keep in mind that Job's warning about the ruinous storm, it's not only the storm, but it's what's coming under it, behind it. You know, they're using the storms to do something that's unseen. Now, to wrap this up, Billy Graham's laying in the Capitol for 2 days during Purim was not by accident. Many people have expounded on that. But I thought about, you know, what happened during Purim? We celebrate. Haman was hung on his own gallows. We're praying that fervently. But also, there were a lot of folks associated with Haman, his sons. There were others who hated the Jews, not like Haman. Haman is a spirit, but there were many that were in association all throughout the land, the swamp. And the swamp had to be drained. The government has to go after and bring about the justice of the government to the lawbreakers. Now, that's not our part. Our part is to wreck hell by reaching into the heavens and praying, pulling down the kings. We know it's a spiritual conflict. You know, the government's got to do their part. Arrest the guys that have broken the laws in this nation over the last many years and gotten away with it. You got to do your job, all of you. We're going to hold you to your task. You got to do it, but we got to do our part. Keep praying. Keep praying. Okay. Let's pray for those that are involved in the presidential prayer watch. You wouldn't believe the warfare that came out of that conference. And I know why now. I know why. This is a big, 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 big thing. And I'm so glad I get to be a part of it. You too. So, Father, we pray. First, we pray for our president. God, help him, Lord. Help him. Give him wisdom. We pray that. Give him discernment. Help him, Lord. We thank you that he's not a perfect man. He's the man you made him to be, but he's our president. You said pray for those in authority. And we know what the enemy's plans are, but we thank you that our God is greater. And so touch him today, guide him, protect him, Lord. Cause Haman to be hung on his own gallows. But Lord, we pray now for all of those. I don't know how many of the 850 are still praying, but I pray, God, ignite fresh fire in the intercession for our president, for our nation in this hour, so that you can do what you want to do. Send another great spiritual awakening to the land. And we thank you, God. Bless those. God bless you. Thank you for being a part of this prayer challenge that we've been commissioned to. Amen.